What's up guys, it's Master Sane here, and welcome back to another video. Now in today's video, what I do have is amazing life hacks which will end up changing your life for the better. And these are just really cool tips or life hacks in which you can do to make your life a whole lot easier. But before we do get into it, the best life hack is to actually leave a like on this video, because the like button will turn blue and you'll actually receive 7 days of good luck if you do leave a like on this video. So make sure that you do leave a like, because you will get 7 days of insanely good luck, which is of course the best life hack. And also make sure to subscribe for that bonus good luck, and then you'll end up being the luckiest person in the world. Also in this video, I'm doing a really huge giveaway. What I'm giving away is 30 iTunes / Google Play cards, and all you need to do to get into them is of course subscribe to the channel, leave a like on the video, and then go on ahead and comment down below saying I subscribe, and comment down below if you would like an iTunes card or a Google Play card. And since there is going to be 30 winners, your chances of winning are going to be quite high. And make sure to turn notifications on so you are notified if you do win. And of course, make sure you do subscribe for more future videos. But with that being said, we will begin today's video. So if your keyboard is actually really dirty and it's got a lot of dust in between and crumbs, then what you can do is actually grab a post-it note or a sticky note and run it between the keys of your keyboard to collect crumbs and fluff. My keyboard is actually getting a little bit dirty, so I might be using this life hack. If you do like to eat strawberries but you don't like the stem, obviously no one likes to eat the stem, then the best thing to do is put a straw in between the middle and it'll remove the stem from the strawberry and you'll just get the good part. If you want to microwave two things at once but obviously there's not enough space in one microwave to fit two bowls, then all you need to do is place a bowl and then place a mug and put another bowl on top of it, and you'll be able to microwave two things at once. If you ever do feel really sick but you don't want to throw up, all you need to do is hum, and while you are humming it is really hard for you to throw up. So if you ever do feel really sick in like a public area and you don't want to be embarrassed throwing up, then just hum. If you ever do get sick and get a sore throat, what you can do is eat a cucumber, and basically eating a cucumber will heal your throat and it won't feel sore anymore. And also if you have a really bad headache, because I know a lot of people do get a headache, this really does help. If you have a really bad headache, all you need to do is lie down and put your feet up against the wall like this, and basically this will really help you eliminate stress and headaches within 5 minutes just by sitting like this. If you have a really warm drink and you want to cool it down really quickly, all you need to do is put a paper towel around it and then put it in the freezer, and in about 15 minutes it will be completely ice cold, and this is the fastest way to get any drink ice cold. To tell if one of your batteries is out of charge or in charge, all you need to do is drop it in the standing up position. If you're ever cooking pancakes and you've got your pancake mix in a bowl and you're using a spoon to bring it over to the pan, it does sometimes make a mess, but what you can do is put that pancake mix in a ketchup bottle and then it will make no mess at all. If you're ever traveling, then keep a bar of scented soap in the same compartment as your dirty laundry, and it will keep your clothes smelling clean. If you want to drink some juice without making a mess at all you need to do is cut a hole in the top corner of the juice carton so it doesn't explode all over your table. If you're ever taking a picture or a selfie and you want your smile to look a lot more genuine, all you need to do is squint your eyes. It makes you appear a lot more happy if you do squint your eyes. I don't really know how it works, but if you do compare the left image to the right one, obviously the right one does look a lot more happier. If you want to fill up a container that doesn't fit in the sink, all you need to place is a clean dustpan and it'll filter all of the water into that container. If you need a book holder or a cookbook holder, all you need is a pants hanger, and basically you place the book in between the pants hanger and it'll just hold up your book so you can just place it on the shelf and read off it as you're cooking or doing other things instead of holding it yourself. This one's really cool. If you use your iPhone light or whatever phone you do have underneath a water bottle, it'll actually make a really cool looking lantern that distributes light a lot better than the direct beam. You can use a spring foam from your old pen to keep your charger from bending and breaking, because I've had a lot of iPhone chargers and a lot of them do end up breaking, especially the cheap ones. But if you do use a spring foam in between it, you will avoid breaking it a whole lot easier. If you don't have enough money for an iPhone speaker but you want your iPhone to transmit at a higher volume, then all you need to do is place your iPhone inside of a toilet paper roll, and basically it'll come through both ends, left and right, and it'll sound kind of like a speaker. Obviously not as good, but it is just a really good do-it-yourself speaker. If you've snapped off your keyboard feet or one of your keyboard feet, then all you need to do is place binder clips and it'll keep your keyboard standing up, even even though you've broken your keyboard feet. You can use a muffin tin to serve condiments at a barbecue, and it'll end up helping you with dishwashing as well, instead of just having separate plates. If you want to start a fire, but you don't really know how to start a fire, then Doritos are really great for kindling a fire. You just light those Doritos on fire, and you know, maybe roast some marshmallows on the Doritos. If you want to identify two different keys a lot more easy, let's say your house keys and your garage keys look really similar, then what you can do is place nail polish on top of them, and this really does help if you have like 15 keys, and then you always remember that your blue key is your house key, and it really just does help. If you put frozen grapes in white wine, it will actually chill it without watering it down, and you can obviously use this on other things, not just white wine. If you have like a million cables in your room and you want to organize them a lot better, then you can use paper clips to organize them. This is a really awesome life hack. If you're almost finished with your jar of Nutella, what you can do is you can end it with ice cream, so you can fill up the other section with ice cream, and then it does taste super, super good. Just trying to get diabetes. If you have an old bottle of lotion or shampoo or whatever, what you can do is turn an old bottle into a simple little cord holder, so you can place your iPhone and then charge your iPhone inside of that little bottle. If you like drinking iced coffee and iced cappuccinos, then what you can do is use frozen coffee cubes to ensure that the drink doesn't get watered down. So instead of using ice to create the iced coffee, what you can do is use iced cubes of coffee, and that'll cool it down while maintaining the coffee-ness. If you're a really heavy sleeper like most people are, and you're tired of snoozing past your alarm, what you can do is use the iPhone in a cup trick to crank up the volume. So just place the iPhone in a cup next to your bedside table, or on the ground if you don't have one, just try not to run into it, and then get that alarm ready. And as soon as the alarm is playing, it will be a lot louder than usual. You can of course try this out yourself, just get a cup and play some music out of it, and it will be louder than usual, because I guess it's something to do with the sound waves in a cup, which end up making it louder. If you put a wooden spoon across a boiling pot of water, it will actually keep it from boiling over. If you're ever lending your friend something in real life, what you need to do is take pictures of your friend holding those items, so you can remember that you lent them those items down the road, so you can get them back from them. If you always get your iPhone headphones mixed up between left and right, what you can do is tangle up the left one a little bit and tie it in a knot, and then you can easily tell which one is left and which one is right. If you put a stocking over the end of a vacuum cleaner, then you can find tiny items like earrings a whole lot easier. This is really cool to make sure you're drinking enough water, because I know most people don't drink enough water, including me. What you can do is put little timings in between how much water you need to drink throughout the day. So you need to drink this much by 2 p.m., this much by 3 p.m., this much by 4 p.m. And it just does really help you drink your recommended amount of water, because obviously if you aren't drinking enough water, then it's hard to go to the toilet, and you can of course get acne, which does suck. You can use a can opener to open blister packs and avoid cutting yourself. If you want to create an awesome sandwich, the best way to create that sandwich is to not overlap. So the best thing you can do is cut both pieces in half, or create one square piece and then cut the other two pieces in half, because then it doesn't overlap. Because if you do it the overlapping way with two circle pieces of ham, then there will be nothing in the corners. If you want to create crunchy taco shells, and then all you need to do is turn your muffin pans upside down, spray with cooking oil, and bake tortillas for approximately 10 minutes at 375 degrees, and then your taco shell will be crunchy instead of being a soft taco shell. This is a really awesome trick to actually carry a lot of groceries in a couple of bags. The right way to make a BLT is to actually mix up and cross-section all of your little bacon pieces to make a square. It really does just look really awesome, and it is the best way to create a BLT. If you enjoy eating hard-boiled eggs, but you really struggle to take the shell off, all you need to do is add 1 teaspoon of baking soda, and it'll make the shell come off really easy without putting in any effort. If you really struggle to eat a cupcake, and you want to eat the cupcake the right way, the best thing to do is unwrap the cupcake, put it on a plate, rip off half of the cupcake, or get a knife and cut it in half, then place that top half on top of the icing half, and that is the proper way to eat a cupcake, because then the icing is in the middle instead of the top, because if you are eating the cupcake from the top, you can be eating all the icing, and then you will have the bottom part of the cupcake without any icing on it. But doing it this way, then you will end up eating icing throughout the entire cupcake. If you stack your clothes vertically, you will end up seeing them all a lot better compared to just stacking them up on each other. If you want to bake some cookies in the summer, but you're outside, maybe you're at the beach, and you don't have an oven with you, what you can do is place them near your windshield, and it'll end up cooking your cookies really good, especially on a really hot day. If you have a dirty blender, but you want to clean it up, then all you need to do is place some soap, place some water, and then turn on the blender and rinse it, and that is the complete best way to clean a blender. The right way to eat a popsicle is to actually put a cupcake wrapper around the bottom end of the popsicle and then go on ahead and eat it that way. If you ever get a stuck zipper and you can't take off your jacket without breaking it, then the best thing to do is to rub that stuck zipper teeth with a graphite pencil tip, and that will end up fixing it, and then you can go ahead and unzip your zipper. If you want to squeeze lemons into a jug or cup without getting your hands dirty and to squeeze them a whole lot easier, then you can use this little cooking utensil to squeeze it out. If you don't have a corkscrew and you really want to open up a bottle, what you can use is the back of the hammer to open up a bottle. If you have a lot of dings in your wooden furniture, what you can do is rub a walnut over those dings, and it'll end up making the dings appear a lot less noticeable, and it will just make your furniture look a lot better. If you have no money at all and want to get some free stuff from a vending machine, I don't really condone you do this because this is of course illegal, but I'm just telling you guys this for education purposes. Then what you can do is, if you are at a Nesquik operated machine, you can type in the code 444-555-44455, and after inputting them, you can select your drink and remove that drink. And that works for Nesquik operated machines, but the code for most soda machines is 432-112311, and then hold down the change lever until you hear a sound of coins raining down, and this will actually get you free change from vending machines. Another way to hack a vending machine is to put money in. This is the method to hack the machine. If you already do have money, then go ahead and select your drink and immediately push down the flap on the door to block the drink from coming in, then wait for the belt to go to the bottom again and look for the machine to say sold out. Then go ahead and choose another selection. And what this will do is give you two drinks for the price of one, because it'll give you the drink in which it thinks is sold out, and then it'll go ahead and give you the drink in which you've chosen right after that one. And this is a trick to trick gumball machines into taking pennies. All you need to do is take a small coin, then wrap layers of foil over it to make it seem bigger and a more valuable coin, and place it in. And you can actually save money doing this because you're only using a penny and the machine thinks it's a bigger amount of money. And this is a method to use fake paper coins in a candy machine. Now what you can do is trick a candy machine with a paper or cardboard coin, and you'll need a fairly old vending machine to do this because the new ones are quite hard to do. And you can also try this on parking meters as well. Now just create a life-size replica of a regular coin in your country, either with paper or cardboard, and you can end up tricking most vending machines. Some older vending machines have a glitch that will return a ripped dollar bill to you while still giving you credit for it. To trick a conveyor belt Coke machine, it's pretty easy to do. All you need to do is insert your money, choose your drink, and stick your hand in the machine and push against the door to confuse it. And instead of saying that the item is sold out, it will give you your money back and still drop you the item, so you can get as many drinks as you want. So you can get like 10 Cokes for only like $2 or however much it is in the soda machine. If you don't want your fingers to get dirty in milk while you are dipping your Oreos in, you can use a fork to place that Oreo in the milk for the correct amount of time, then take it out and eat it yourself without dunking it in and making a mess. If you always end up losing your remote, and it is pretty annoying and stressful to lose your remote, what you can do is get a little sticky holder and place it on each side of the remote, and then place that on the table and just put it right there, so you will always remember where to place your remote, unless you drop it. If you need to pee or smoke at a bar, placing your coaster on top of your drink is universal bar language for "I'm coming back," which does prevent you from losing your drink and seat. If you want to keep your crust from getting chewy, what you can do is place a small amount of water in a glass when you microwave your pizza, and it'll end up keeping the crust from getting chewy. If you want to store your cables in your backpack or suitcase without making a mess, you can use a pencil case or a sunglasses case to store those cables. You guys have actually been eating chips and snacks wrong your entire life, what you need to do is get a bag of your favorite snacks, open the bag, and then go ahead and roll it from the bottom. And just keep rolling it till the chips or snacks are at the top. And then the bag will be a lot more smaller and you won't dirty your hands on the edges of the bag because the chips are at the top. And then as you keep eating, just keep rolling up the bag. And it does create a little snack bowl, which is really cool if you don't have a bowl or don't want to dirty a bowl. If you want bananas to stay fresh for longer, what you can do is keep a plastic wrap over the banana stems and it will make them stay fresh over a week or longer. And then you can just cut bananas off when needed. These are going to be running shoelacing techniques. Number one is the black toenail. Number two, heel slipping. Number three, high instep. Number four, narrow forefoot. Number five, overall rumor fit. And number six, wide forefoot. And that is obviously the best six ways to tie up your running shoes. If you want to eat Pringles without making any crumbs, all you need to do is, this is actually the best way to eat those Pringles, because as you are eating the Pringles, crumbs will fall onto the paper, and then you can eat those crumbs and continue eating the Pringles without making a mess on your desk. If you want to get ice water on the go, fill a water bottle a quarter of the way through with water, then turn it sideways and put it in your freezer to freeze. When it's frozen, fill up the rest of the bottle with water and you'll have ice cold water on the go. But anyway, that is going to be the end of today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy the video. If you did make it to the end, you are an awesome person. But anyway, that's all from me. Peace out, guys.